It's a brutal truth. It's going to hurt my asset management industry. But if you want to keep your customer and you want to build a long-term relationship with him, the faster you move to this model, the better for all of you. Please don't record this. But that's the brutal, honest truth. If your customer base is HNI, because not only is this going to happen, he's going to have a hold of bankers, hold of wealth managers, hold of flip cards, everybody going and hitting him. So you take the lagam in your hands and you ride the horse in a proper way. And if, however, you are in a retail, then I would recommend that you stick to distribution. Right? Because in retail, the challenge of that NAV is not so great, right? And so the retail customer is also going to be that much harder to pay any money. Even 100 rupees, he will think 100 times. So you can't extract by being an RIA to retail. You are in the bum end of both sides of the business. So if your customer base is largely retail, you have to stick with the distribution model. Next, you talked about customer challenges, right? So what is the solution to this? We already spoke about it. Communication and branding, collaboration and bonding. This is the two mantras, because all of this, once you are collaborating, creating the solution with him, the panic, the short-termism, all of that can be managed, saying, sir, you only suggested it. We both discussed it, right? So I think this one can easily be solved if you create a brand so that the trust is there in you. For the trust, they will pay a price. That's why for a Sony TV, you pay double for a Videocon TV. So both are manufactured in the same plant in Thailand. That's the reality. Why? Because the brand, you trust. The after-sales service of Sony, you know, even when Sony was imported in India, you could get it repaired anywhere in India. So that trust is what that brand builds. All this issue about cost and, you know, panic, everything will get solved if you build a strong, powerful personal brand, and if you create a beautiful bond with the customer where you co-create the investment solution, right? Next problem, AMCs. So what's the answer to this? Change your mindset, my dear friends. Think customer, act customer, demand for the customer. Don't let an AMC person win you over with his sales and marketing tactics. Everything that comes to you, you think, is it good for the customer? Execute for the customer, and if customer needs something, demand it from them for the customer. That's the only way to tackle AMCs at the other end of the spectrum, is if you're always customer focused, you don't get yourself focused. Your revenues should not be the key driver in this. The AMCs are able to exploit you because you are revenue centric. Right? Pavlovian, you throw a dog to the dog for a dog biscuit. So, please, this is very serious. Like I said, I want to be honest and transparent to you about this. It is our job as AMCs to sell our products. It's not that we are doing wrong, but it's up to you to resist, up to you to challenge us, up to you to say, my customer will get hurt if I do this. So, no. That needs a lot of guts from your end, because sometimes you might be giving up revenue. But yes, you still have to do that. Otherwise, you are going to come back to the same problem. Next, costs. For costs, I think the answer is very, very clear, right? Leverage technology, leverage platforms, leverage AMCs. Right? You have your own technology. That's one. Platforms, MFI, MFU, BSC, MSC Star, whole lot of platforms. AMCs, how do you leverage AMCs? One is direct connectivity to debiting bank account and doing. Second is IAPs. Take the cost of acquiring a customer, you please outsource it to the AMCs. There's huge budget of IAP budget available with the entire manufacturing industry, right? So now we come to the capitalization opportunity, right? So this is my final point which I want to make to you. And again, it's a very brutal, and I'm going to say one statement right at the beginning, okay? What is this? Fortune lies at the... So even when I said earlier that for HNIs, you should become an RIA, like I said, if there's an opportunity for you to become a distributor in your wife or your brother or your sister's name, take that and go retail. The long-term HNI business is not a sustainable proposition. Because even the costliest, sorry, richest HNI will hesitate to give you 25,000 rupee check. So every one of you, while to protect the HNI business, has to overcome the challenge, you need to come RIA. You have to build a retail business model, every single person in this room. I will not accept to say, no, I'm only HNI, I hate retail. No, you're going to harm yourself. The future is in this. Why? Why? Demographics. Beautiful answer. Thank you, ma'am. I'm happy that. Right? It's the demographics of the country. It's the retail people. The per capita income is rising. If you don't tap that opportunity at the bottom of the pyramid, that's one. Second, when I talked about the life expectancy, what you need to do from today, the trick lies in thinking and acting. So how much is long term? How many say 10 years? Why this 20 years? Remember, 20 years is the extension in the average Indian life expectancy. I said that your customer is going to live till 75, which means even to a 55-year-old customer, you can sell a 20-year product. Right? Why you want to go and sell a 10-year product to him? And then 10 years later, you want to sell another 10-year product to him. Think now for 20 years. And it's not from the customer perspective. After all, I'm addressing you all. Right? Think about your life, yaar. Are you not going to live to 75? Unless you build an asset book which is going to be giving you revenue for 20 years, how are you? You are going to constantly, when your son comes into the business, you have to give him a legacy. You can't say, you, abe beta, ab tu shuruaat se start kar. You have to build a legacy. Unless you think 20 years about your business and your customer's business, it's not going to get solved. So what I have done here is I have taken a model retail customer. Because I don't know how many of you, we all do SIP projection for customer for long term, right? We easily take a lot of 20-year SIPs or 25-year SIPs and all of that. How many of you think of our own business for 20 years and what it means? And we all hate retail. We say, "Arey, chota customer ki piche kon jayega?" I just want in two slides to demonstrate to you that the potential of retail is something which will make you fall out of your chair today. Okay? So don't sit tight on your chair. Don't fall and make me embarrassed. So first is, what have I assumed about this model retail customer? I've assumed that he is a 10 lakhs salary. I assume that when you go and get him as a customer, he gives you an SIP allocation of 12% of his income. Reasonable? Right? So that comes to 10,000 bucks per month. I'm sorry, that was a typo there. That's 10,000 rupees per month SIP. That's how it's 1,20,000 out of 10 lakhs. Right? He gets a salary increment of 10% per annum. Right? So what does he do? Every year, you take a 10% more SIP allocation. Reasonable? That means next year you take 11,000. Next year you take 10% of 11,000 more. Means 1,200. Is that reasonable? This is not too ambitious. And in lowering the expense ratio, lowering the commissions, you'll all question me, sir, your basic assumptions, how long it will last? So I've taken brutally honest assumptions, which is what? Upfront 0%. SIP incentive, 0%. Trail commission, 1%. Reasonable? If expense ratios, what SEBI is thinking is to cap it at 175. If he caps it at 175, getting 1% from the AMCs is not going to be a challenge, right? Many of you will get much more. But as a base assumption, 1% is reasonable or not? Right? Because I don't want you to come back to the slide and say, revisit that. Okay? Are we on board? Next. I am taking an inflation assumption of 7% per annum for the next 20 years. Now, this is overambitious. We are saying low inflation, but I want to be overcautious. Because what am I going to do with this 7%? On the one hand, you are to deliver excess of 7% to the customer, correct? Right? But if you have to evaluate a customer, in the next slide, I am going to ask you to think of the customer like a stock. When you invest in a stock, what do you want? You want dividends and you want capital appreciation. Correct? And when that capital appreciation happens in a stock, what do fund managers do? DCF. What is DCF? Discounted cash flows, which means what? In arriving at the intrinsic value or the fundamental value of a stock, you project the future cash flows and discount them back to today's value, which in capital budgeting is called NPV. So DCF is our financial market of saying, in capital budgeting is called NPV. NPV and DCF are one and the same. So what rate? What I'm trying to do is, if you're buying a stock and you want to arrive at the intrinsic fundamental value, you will project the future earnings and then you will discount it to today. And today you will compare with the market price and buy it if it is selling at less than your fundamental value. Correct or wrong? So you should know, each customer, what is the NPV to you? And I've assumed a customer of a very normal retail, right? You are agreed with me on this? On the basis of the previous slide, right? The future value of an SIP at 20 years is 1.4. The SIP that I have laid out there is 1.58 crores future value. Nominal commission you would have received will be per customer 10.2 lakhs at that 1% rail without upfront, without SIP. You discount it at the inflation rate because both the customer should get better value. So what have I assumed this growth? I'm sorry, I should have written. I have used 12%. 12% as the appreciation that your advice is going to deliver to the customer. Is that reasonable? 12%, because long-term average of the Sensex for the last 30 years is 13.3%. Last 20 years, it's 12%, right? So 12% is a reasonable assumption. That's what I've used. I'm sorry, I didn't write it there. So when you discount this 1.58 crores at 7% per annum, the customer today, he's already a crorepati. Okay? That 1.58 crore of future SIP value is worth today 1 crore. And the value of your earnings from that customer, the 10.12 lakhs, is equal to 7 lakhs. And all of you read Wealth Forum? Wealth Forum, Brijesh Dalmia had put something. What was it? The magic number is 600, he said. What he meant was, if you solicit 600 people, you'll get 200 active customers. So I'm just borrowing from his. If you have 200 retail customers, what is the present value of your business? 14 crore rupees, my dear friends. Right? Why this deep silence? So please don't ignore retail. There's a huge fortune waiting at the end of the rainbow, right? You, with just 200 active customers giving you 10,000 rupees SIP per month, growing it at 10% per annum, the present value of your business is 14 crore rupees. Why this despondency? Capitalize on the opportunity. Do not ignore retail. Thank you very much, my dear friends.